moves. For example, first, choke from behind, rear choke. This choke can be done in many different ways. There is some deadly move called neck crank, which also you should know. Look at this, he's stepping out before I even touch him. But here you can learn how to defend yourself from all this stuff. Look at this, like a little raiders. My hands blocking him at the beginning, so there is no way you can do anything. If he tried to do this, on contrary, I have a little secret Russian technique how you can go through, how you can penetrate to a person's body. Так у нас эти баранов разделывает. I see that how when you get the lamb and how you got the, you know, get the skin out of the body. So this is the way, try to resist pull the way. See this? It goes through, you know, those small things. I mean, I promise in a month or 2 months, you know a lot of those things which can put you aside from everyday public. We're gonna practice some jiu-jitsu moves, and lately Brazilian jiu-jitsu became so popular. All those techniques gonna be practiced here, at least the stuff which works. And 15 years ago, when I brought samba to this country, there are some technique. Brazilians found that some of their technique doesn't work anymore because of the new secret Russian moves, like they would call it back then. Like, for example, okay, we landed nicely, softly, without any resistance. And like, for example, people try to block. This is a guard position. So in jiu-jitsu, there are like millions, zillions of ways to pass this guard. And what I found that if you know some samba technique, you don't really need to pass this guard. Like, what's the reason? Like, for example, I would control one arm, extend the hip, stick one knee in the middle, and land in position where you just have the leg lock. Thank you. Same thing, when somebody grabs it from behind, even like get the strong grip, you can try to break this hold with your hands. It's impossible even for me, see, because my triceps has to work, right? It's impossible. But if you make yourself look like a ball and drop all your weight, see, it breaks by itself. Plus, I don't want to let him go. Since I'm already here, I would end up in a heel lock position. If it's tough, do it on your feet. I would go bring him on the ground, then finish him here. For people who want to learn more advanced technique, of course, ladies, not, you don't have to do this. I'm just giving it for, showing it for a man. Again, somebody grabs you and you feel there is no way you can break this hold. You don't even need to break this hold. You can just simply dive and get the leg lock. And this is also, this technique came from Russia, and many people for 15 years tried to repeat this, and they still cannot, because there are so many details in it. And there is a special way to teach this move. That's why for 15 years it hasn't been done yet. And I promise people who come to the dojo will know this technique if they want, of course, in a day or so. And look at how much easier it works when you're on the ground, how much safer. Look at this. And people always try to rush and try to go get on the feet. It doesn't work. Speaking of, again, I'm addressing to men. Look at this. Just a regular knee bar. Some people might gonna grab it, break your, crutch, hurt yourself, and wouldn't succeed. Like, I remember my buddy Ken Shamrock, he done it to some people who had no knowledge in how to defend yourself, and he hurt himself worse than the guy. And look how many techniques you should know to do it perfectly. The way you cross your feet, the way you hit the tailbone, the way you grab, not Achilles tendons, but the heel, the way you turn the foot, the way you make it shorter, and pain comes out of nowhere. See? It's not, for sure you have to tap out the pain so people understand. So look at the difference. This is the regular way. See how long it takes until I, and look at the right away. Pain comes right away, immediately. So those small details, I think you all should know, because that makes the difference. That's when some lady like you, capable to finish guy like him, for example. Like him, yeah. Yeah, you should, in fact, yeah. Right. If someone wants to know, there are zillion techniques using the gi, and judo jiu-jitsu, it's very similar. Somehow Japanese, when they start losing on the ground, they start removing all the ground technique. So that's why jiu-jitsu is much better when it comes to ground, because it used to be they all been the same. It all came from, if you the first guy who thought Gracie family came from Japan, and he was originally an old judo teacher. And old judo had all of the stuff. Now, the rules and stuff. Right, so anything you would like to know, I could show a technique all day long. For me, it's a pleasure. For example, since ladies are more excited about stuff, so here I am. Just about being raped. Look at this, how many sweeps you have. This is the first sweep, most simple one. Again, trying to attack me. Whoa. Another sweep, and you can do it with any guy, like Roman, come on here. Because... Look at this. See? Once I perfectly balance my weight and everything. So I guess it doesn't matter if it's 150 pounds or 220 pounds or 50 pounds. It's the same thing when you know the right technique, right position. And from the top, we have tons of moves. Like, for example, if you get on the top, there are all kind of neck cranks, all kind of chokes, all kind of arm locks, leg locks, Achilles. This is a tall hook. Tall hook. Sorry. Yeah, Roman asked me to show some moves which hasn't been done in any competition for many years. We call it a canary, the bird that sings. Mm-hmm. Special. Yeah. In jiu-jitsu people don't know it, and it would be a cool idea if you combine it with a choke technique, arm technique, and suddenly if it doesn't work, you come to this side,